Oh, good morning. Just wanted to give you a little detail on that the flashing wall I was talking to you about yesterday, and how the siding interfaces with the shingles. And this is let me back up here. This is our showroom. Here we are right here in Dearborn, and there's Telegraph. Okay, this is our roofing display. Remember, siding kiosk right here showing off our different siding, and we have this wall interface where we can kind of explain how flashing walls are done. You see the siding coming down. You see our step flashing right here, our Tyvek ice and water shield. So this is called our J channel. As you can see, it's right here. This is a piece that I took out from our warehouse here. And as you can see, if it's nailed here, when it's nailed after the roof is installed, it's nailed into the step flashing right here. So as you can see, how it would be a little challenging to install the roofing and the underlayments and everything behind the siding without having to remove any of the J channels. So what we would do is take a special tool, goes up behind the siding, and then we can then unzip the siding all the way across and then remove the individual sidings. We would have to pull this stuff off, unnail it, so we can get our step flashing, ice and water shield, and so forth behind the Tyvek and the siding, and then we can reinstall the siding and J-channel, maybe put down this decorative trim piece right here. So it kind of gives you an idea of what it entails to do the flashing at your siding wall, and why I recommended removing the siding so we can get all of this, the ice and water shield, the step flashing up behind the siding, and give you a nice weathertight seal.